on this day 5 years ago, that is 30th of June 2015, Kerala lost one of its most important sons, an individual who contributed so much to modern Kerala's development. Tens of thousands of families are indebted to him for what they are today. Many of them really don't know that it was that he was the person behind what they are today. For me and for many others, he was a fatherly figure. I'm talking about the late KPP Nambiar, the man behind the electronic revolution in the country, the man who actually made Kerala a pioneer in state electronics development, the person behind the setting up of India's first state-level electronic development corporation, India's first electronics research and development center at the state level, India's first technology park, the Technopark at Trivandrum, the person behind the Center for Development of Advanced Computing, the person behind the Center for Materials Technology in Electronics, the Center for Development of Electronic Design, a person who actually was so attached to Kerala that everything he did during a major part of his career actually had a benefit for Kerala. If you look at what he did in terms of setting up Keltron, the way Keltron was brought up, the way Keltron spread across Kerala. Keltron was not only a state electronics development corporation. Keltron actually played a major role in making Kerala at that time a manufacturing base for electronics. Because the plants that he set up were not in the cities, they were in the outskirts. Whether it be the factory at Karakulam, the factory at Mudadi, the factory at Arur, and many others, they were all away from the city. And he actually spread development from the heart of the cities to many other places. Today we talk about decentralized or distributed manufacturing. KPP did that decades ago when he set up the Women Electronic Manufacturing Cooperatives, which manufactured radios, assembled radios, and then got them quality certified by Keltron and sold under the Keltron brand. It is very difficult to really talk about such an individual, but there is so much to say, and you know, 5 minutes or 30 minutes or 1 hour will not be enough. But let me point out a few things which are important. From Keltron, that impact was known. Several other state governments copied what he did and created the other state development corporations. But the interesting thing is that most of those state electronic development corporations were headed by people who initially worked in Keltron, whether it be Uptron or Meltron or many of the others. Several major names that you see today in the market, like NIIT or Suntech and several others, actually had people who worked in Keltron under him who actually moved out to set up companies of their own. But what is most important is that when he left here, when he was invited by the then Prime Minister to go to Delhi to take over the Indian telephone industries, to take it further, actually what he did was he actually invested so much in the ITI plant at Kanjikode. I don't think Kerala can ever forget an individual like him. He then went on to become the Secretary Department of Electronics, actually the last non-IAS person to take on that position. And during that period, several new initiatives were set up. The software technology part started just around that time. But what was very important was he set up the Electronic Regional Test Laboratories, the Center for Electronic Material Technology, the Center for Electronic Design Technology, the Center for Development of Advanced Computing. All these projects actually had an institution of theirs within the state of Kerala. His love for Kerala was so much. I first saw him during my college days and looked up to him so much. But I did not get the chance to personally meet with him and interact with him until I decided to be part of the Technopark project. In fact, the seminar and before that when we used to meet, based on what my then boss, Dr. Butker, wanted me to interact with him. I saw in him a person so determined, a person with so much of energy. Difficult to say that how could someone have that kind of energy at that age. But that was the kind of person he was. There was never a word like cannot do for him. It was always, we will do it. There was never a job that is impossible. It was always that it is possible. And that is what KPP was. So in the Technopark, setting up of the Technopark, he was very clear that it had to be of international standards. And I'm so happy that we've left behind a legacy for him. The thing is that many people who work in Technopark today don't really know that he was the brain behind that project. actually, I'm not talking about a lot of other things which are there. But I just want to say that this gentleman, Sri K.P. Pinnambiyar, contributed so much for modern Kerala's development. I don't think there is anyone else who can really claim to have that to their credit. Thank you very much. May his soul rest in peace. And at this point of time, I remember his family, Uma Nambiar, son Kiran, and the kind of ongoing work that they have done in terms of remembering KPP. Thank you very much.